Welcome back, everybody, for another deep dive. This time, we're going to be exploring a really interesting connection, the one between your physical health and your personal power.
Oh, yeah.
We've got this article here. It blends ancient wisdom with modern science.
This sounds fascinating.
It suggests that taking care of your body can unlock hidden potential, like it's a key to a whole new level of you.
I love that idea.
It is pretty cool, right?
Yeah.
So what do you think about this, we often view our bodies as just these vehicles for daily life.
Right.
This is saying it's so much more than that.
Exactly. Yeah, the source suggests that our bodies are powerful tools for self-discovery and creative expression.
Okay.
And even for connecting with the energy of the entire universe.
Whoa, okay, hold on. I'm already hooked. So tell me more. Like, where do we even begin with this?
Well, the article starts with a pretty bold statement.
Okay.
It says, your body is your most valuable asset.
Okay.
More valuable than gold, cars, anything.
More than a house.
Even a house.
Wow.
It compares our bodies to antennas.
Resonating
with planets, stars, the elements.
Really? It's a powerful image, right?
Very powerful, very evocative.
I can kind of see it, you know, like we are all part of this bigger cosmic dance.
Exactly. And, you know, this idea isn't new.
Right.
Ancient cultures have been exploring this connection for centuries.
That's true.
Think about all the ways they describe the body. A microcosm of the universe, a temple of the divine, a bridge to other dimensions.
Yeah, yeah, right.
They understood there's something really profound going on here.
So how do we take these ancient ideas and bring them into our modern world?
That's a great question.
Because I'm all about tapping into the universe, but I also have to, you know, go to work, do laundry, like live my daily life.
Of course. And that's where I think the practical benefits of good physical health really come in.
Okay.
The article highlights a lot of things we already know. Less risk of disease, better mood, improved sleep, weight management.
Right.
All that good stuff. But it goes a step further. It suggests that good physical health can actually boost your brain power, really make you a better athlete, and even enhance your spiritual practices.
Oh, wow.
It's all connected.
I like that. So it's not just about living longer. It's about living better.
Exactly.
What about the opposite, though? Like, what happens if we neglect our bodies?
Yeah, the article's pretty clear about that.
Okay.
Neglecting your body leads to chronic illness, pain, and even self-hate.
Wow.
It's a stark warning, but a necessary one. Mm. You know, it really emphasizes the importance of taking care of ourselves.
So taking care of our bodies is really important for all this, but how do we actually unlock this physical potential?
Well, the article does offer some practical guidance.
Okay, good.
It recommends exercise, strength training, plant-based diet, stress management.
It's all the usual stuff.
It is, but then it goes a little bit beyond just the basics.
Okay.
It emphasizes listening to your body's signals.
Like
those aches, pains, cravings, even rejections.
Interesting. So it's not just about following some generic plan.
Right.
It's about really tuning in to what our bodies are telling us.
Exactly. The article encourages us to see our bodies as finely tuned instruments.
Okay.
That need specific care and attention.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
So what kind of specific care are we talking about?
Well, the article dives into some fascinating areas like using crystals.
Crystals?
Yeah, like garnet and malachite to work with the body's energy.
Okay, I've heard about that, but I never really looked into how would they even work.
Everything in the universe is made up of energy, right?
Yeah.
Our bodies, too, and crystals, with their unique structures and vibrations, they interact with our energy fields.
Interesting.
Some people believe they can amplify certain energies, help clear blockages.
So you're using crystals to fine-tune your body's energy.
Yeah, like a cosmic tuning fork.
I like that analogy.
It's important to remember that crystal healing is a complementary practice.
Oh, of course.
Not a replacement for traditional healthcare.
Right. Are there any other practices the article mentions to help us tap into our body's potential?
It talks about fasting, detoxing, and cleansing.
Okay.
Not as, like, trendy fads, but as powerful tools for enhancing physical and mental well-being.
I've always been curious about those. What does the article say about them?
Well, it highlights the potential benefits of each practice.
Okay.
For example, fasting, when done safely and correctly, it's linked to weight loss, improved blood sugar and cholesterol levels, reduced inflammation, even increased cell repair.
Wow, that's pretty impressive.
Mm-hmm.
What about detoxing?
You hear so many things about it.
Yeah, what does it even mean?
The article focuses on the idea that detoxing helps remove toxins that build up in our bodies.
Makes sense.
From things like environmental pollutants, processed foods, and medication.
Oh, yeah.
Detoxing can lead to increased energy and better digestion.
So it's like giving our body a spring cleaning from the inside out.
Hmm, you could say that. Wow. And finally, the article talks about cleansing, which is presented as a holistic approach to improve digestive health, boost immunity, reduce inflammation, and even enhance mental stability.
So it sounds like fasting, detoxing, and cleansing are all about resetting and restoring balance in our bodies.
Yeah, basically.
They sound pretty intense, though. Is it safe to just jump into those?
That's a really important point.
Yeah.
It's crucial to approach these practices with caution.
Okay.
And as always, consult with a healthcare professional to figure out the right approach for your individual needs.
Right. Safety first. The article also talks about taking action and self-accountability. What does it mean by that?
It's about putting all this knowledge into practice.
Yeah.
Making real changes in your life.
Uh-huh.
It emphasizes that small changes done consistently can make a huge difference.
So not overhauling your life overnight.
Right.
But making sustainable changes you can stick with.
Exactly. And the article offers some actionable steps.
Oh, good.
To help us do that.
Okay.
It starts with setting specific and achievable goals.
Like, what do I want to achieve physically?
Exactly. What do you want to achieve?
I guess I'd like to have more energy, feel stronger, and just feel more comfortable in my own skin.
Those are great goals.
Thanks.
Once you have that vision, the next step is to create a plan.
Okay.
The article suggests breaking down your goals into smaller, manageable steps.
Uh-huh.
Almost like reverse engineering your success.
I love that term, reverse engineering.
Yeah.
Working backwards from where you want to be to figure out how to get there.
Exactly. And don't forget, you don't have to do this alone.
That's true.
The article stresses the importance of finding a support system.
Okay.
Friends, family, a personal trainer, or even online communities.
Oh, yeah.
Having people around you that believe in you can make all the difference.
It's like having cheerleaders on the sidelines rooting you on.
Exactly. And to stay motivated, the article recommends tracking your progress.
That's good.
Keeping a journal, using a fitness app.
Right.
It's about celebrating your wins and learning from any setbacks you might encounter.
So it's not about being perfect, but about being consistent and learning along the way.
Exactly. And don't forget to reward yourself.
That's important.
Self-love is a key part of the journey.
I like that.
Taking a relaxing bath, enjoying a healthy treat. It's about acknowledging your effort and celebrating your progress.
Self-care is definitely important. Mm-hmm. But what happens if I hit a roadblock? What if I need help?
Well, that's where the article's emphasis on self-accountability comes in.
Okay.
It reminds us that it's okay to ask for help.
Yeah.
In fact, it's a sign of strength, not weakness.
I like that.
Whether it's seeking guidance from a health professional or confiding in a trusted friend.
Right.
Just remember that you don't have to go it alone.
That's true. It's easy to feel like we have to do everything ourselves.
Right.
But sometimes reaching out is exactly what we need.
Exactly. And, you know, self-accountability is an ongoing process.
Okay.
It's about being honest with yourself, acknowledging any areas where you might be struggling, and just recommitting to your goals.
Even when you face obstacles.
Especially when you face obstacles.
So staying committed to the journey, even when things get tough.
Exactly. The article reminds us that lasting change takes time and effort.
True.
It's about cultivating patience, persistence, and belief in your ability to transform.
It's like that saying, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
Precisely. And as you take those steps, remember to be kind to yourself.
Yes.
Celebrate your progress.
That's so important.
And never underestimate the power of small, consistent actions.
I think we've taken a pretty deep dive today into the extraordinary power of the human body.
We did.
We explored its connection to the cosmos, all those incredible benefits of physical well-being.
It's fascinating.
And all those practical ways to unlock our full potential.
Uh-huh.
It's amazing to think that something as simple as taking care of ourselves can have such a profound impact on our lives.
Yeah, we started by exploring ancient wisdom, touched upon modern science.
Yeah.
We even delved into the intriguing world of crystals and energy healing. But ultimately, it all comes back to the power we have within ourselves to create positive change.
And that's a really empowering message, I think. If our bodies truly are microcosms of the universe, just imagine the possibilities that open up when we're physically and energetically aligned.
I love that.
It's like we have a whole universe of potential just waiting to be unlocked.
What if by nurturing our physical health, we're not just improving our individual well-being, but we're also tapping into a greater source of energy and power?
Okay.
What if it connects us to something far beyond ourselves? It's a fascinating concept to explore.
We hope this deep dive has sparked your curiosity and inspired you to embark on your own journey of self-discovery and physical empowerment.
Remember, the resources and practices we discussed are just a starting point.
Yeah.
There's a whole world of knowledge out there waiting to be discovered.
So keep learning, keep experimenting, and keep pushing those boundaries of what you believe is possible.
Your body truly is your greatest asset. Treat it with care and respect, and you might be amazed at what you can achieve.
Until next time, keep diving deep. Okay, so for our listeners out there who are, you know, really intrigued by this and want to start their own...
Yeah, they want to dive in.
They want to dive into their own lifestyle alchemy journey. Where should they go? What should they do?
Well, there's a fantastic resource I always recommend. It's called MoorishBrooklyn.com.
MoorishBrooklyn.com.
Yeah, they've got a ton of information on all things lifestyle alchemy.
Wow.
From, you know, really practical tips.
Okay.
On how to improve your mental health.
Yeah.
Boost your physical well-being.
Right.
To some really insightful articles on spiritual growth.
Yeah, cover it all.
And even financial literacy.
The whole game.
It's all there.
Okay, perfect. So we'll make sure to include a link to MoorishBrooklyn.com in the episode description.
Please do.
Yeah, check that out.